Alexis Carrasco, and after learning about one of the school shootings, it's kind of sad that I don't remember which one. I decided to educate myself upon what was happening because I felt absolutely useless. And I learned about a foundation that had happened called Choose Love by one of the mothers of the Sandy Hook. Her child was killed. And one of the systems in it was to implement social and care into school systems and communities. And that also ties in with Kenya nonviolence. So how can we implement those values into school societies and communities and still have people listen to us?
Our Senator Bill Nelson passed something that was really interesting as like a tag along to one of a bill that passed. It was a bill that had nothing to do with this, but he like got this little thing in there to test run more social services in schools, like to put $10 million into hiring more social workers, because right now there's, I forgot the statistic, but there a majority of our schools do not have any social workers, and then on top of that, more schools have like nowhere near the amount that is necessary to actually deal with the students. And so I think a lot of that has to just be funded by the federal government and by the state government to actually have people in schools that can deal with people who are dealing with trauma or stress or mental illness of any kind. Because I knew when I was growing up, I had nowhere to go in school if I was feeling like things were going wrong or to properly report things. A lot of the time, they are told not to take responsibility. And I think better funding in these schools to have programs that actually teach people how to be more compassionate and have a place to go and to talk through these issues and to have conflict mediation. One of the most successful ways to end gun violence in the inner city is violence intervention programs, and adapting those into schools would be life-saving. And so it is a multifaceted issue, but we need to show people that, like, the data is now there in the last few years through these violence interruption programs that they work, and just about presenting those to people who actually care about facts and having people in office that care about facts and real solutions instead of talking about things that don't actually add up to helping people. And so a lot of it is about electing people to local office and state office that represent our values and listen to facts. But on top of that, it's also about, like, just having that sort of attention to know that this is a problem, that there are no facilities for this. If it's easier to get a gun than it is to get mental health care, then there's something wrong in your community.